Today we will talk about stability and determinacy. We will explain what is stability and what is determinacy, and what is the relation between the two, and how we can evaluate the stability and determinacy of a structure. So what is a stable structure? Stability is related to the ability of a structure to reach equilibrium. If a structure can reach equilibrium for any possible force configuration imposed on it, then the structure is stable. If there exists a group of forces which, when imposed on the structure, equilibrium can't be reached, then the structure is unstable. As an example, to clarify this idea, consider the shown beam. Under the influence of vertical forces, the actions provided by the roller support will balance the acting forces and equilibrium can be reached. But when the beam is subjected to horizontal force, the roller supports will not be able to generate a horizontal reaction to balance the acting force, and equilibrium cannot be attained, and the beam will move. Because equilibrium cannot be reached for all possible forces, then the beam is unstable. To make the beam stable, we can change one of the roller supports to a hinged support. This will enable the beam to resist the horizontal force and generate the required horizontal reactions needed for equilibrium. Because now the beam can attain equilibrium for all the possible forces, then the beam becomes stable. So what is a determinate structure? If the structure can be solved using the equilibrium equations alone, then the structure is determinate. But if the equilibrium equations are not enough and additional equations are needed, then the structure is indeterminate. The degree of indeterminacy is equal to the number of additional equations needed to solve the structure. To solve a structure statically, the first step is to evaluate the unknown forces. The unknowns are classified into external unknowns, which are the support reactions, and internal unknowns, which are caused by closed frame loops. The number of internal unknowns is equal to the number of closed frame loops multiplied by 3. To solve for the unknown forces, equilibrium equations must be generated, which are obtained by balancing the acting forces and the reactions. Equilibrium equations consist of the 3 main equilibrium equations, sigma x, sigma y, and sigma m, and the equilibrium equations caused due to the presence of the intermediate hinges. So, how many equations will be generated by the intermediate hinge? To answer this question, we concentrate on the frame elements attached to the hinge. The number of equilibrium equations generated by the hinge is equal to the number of independent rotations that can happen around the hinge after clamping one of the surrounding elements. To investigate the stability and determinacy of a structure, the following steps must be followed. First, we must evaluate and compare the number of unknowns and number of equilibrium equations. If the number of equilibrium equations is larger than the number of unknowns, then the structure is definitely unstable. If the number of equilibrium equations is equal to the number of unknowns, then the structure is probably stable and determinate. If the number of equilibrium equations is less than the number of unknowns, then the structure is probably stable but indeterminate. Now let us solve some examples. The shown frame has 2 supports, one hinged support with 2 reactions and one roller support with 1 reaction. So the total number of reactions is 3. Because there are no closed frame loops, the number of internal unknowns is 0. Therefore, the total of unknowns is 3. The total number of equilibrium equations is 4. The 3 main equations plus 1 equation from the intermediate hinge. Because the number of equilibrium equations is larger than the number of unknowns, then the structure is unstable. The instability of the frame can be visualized easily if we applied a horizontal force at the top left corner. As a follow-up to the previous example, if we exchange the roller support at the right end by a hinged support, the number of reactions will be increased. The total reactions will be 4 instead of 3. Therefore, the number of equilibrium equations will now be equal to the number of unknowns, and the frame will become stable and determinate. Now, let us look at another example. The frame shown has two supports, a hinged support and a roller support. The total reaction is 3. The frame has two closed loops, so the number of internal unknowns is 2 loops multiplied by 3, which is equal to 6. So the total number of unknowns is 9. The equilibrium equations consist of the three main equations as usual, plus the equations due to the hinge. If we concentrate on the hinge, we will figure out that the hinge is connected to three frame elements. If we clamp one of the elements, the other two elements can rotate independent of each other. So the hinge will provide two additional equilibrium equations. Therefore, the total number of equilibrium equations is 5. For this frame, the number of equilibrium equations is less than the number of unknowns, so the frame is stable and indeterminate. The degree of indeterminacy is equal to 4. As a follow-up to the previous example, if the hinge at the top is lowered to be below the top frame elements, then the hinge will allow only one independent rotation instead of two, and the number of equations provided by the hinge will be 1. In this case, the frame will still be stable and indeterminate, but the degree of indeterminacy will increase to be 5. Let us look at the last example. The frame shown has two supports, a fixed support with 3 reactions, and a roller support with 1 reaction, making the total reactions to be 4. The frame has also one closed loop, so the number of internal unknowns is 3. Therefore, the total number of unknowns is 7. The total number of equilibrium equations is 5, which consists of the three main equations plus 2 equations from the intermediate hinge, because the hinge provides 2 independent rotations. Therefore, the frame is stable and 2 times indeterminate.